student leaders change their constitution. Good afternoon. I'm Daisy Colon. Thanks for joining us for the final edition of Bobcat Update this year. There have been some major reforms to the student government constitution. In order to meet higher ethical standards, student government last night ratified what is called the Constitutional Overhaul Act of 2019. The revised document places the interests of individual students as a higher priority and limits the powers of student government officials. 21 of the 23 senators voted in favor of the reform. The Texas State volleyball team will find out Sunday who it plays in the first round of the NCAA tournament. The Bobcats are headed for postseason play by virtue of their winning the Sun Belt Championship this past weekend. They defeated Coastal Carolina in four sets at Strahan Arena. The tournament's most valuable player was Cheyenne Husky, who had 17 kills. In other sports, the men's basketball team is winning big lately. Just last night, the Bobcats defeated the Abilene Christian Wildcats 61-56, making it their 12th straight non-conference win at home. The victory also makes the Bobcats 3-0 in the Southwestern Showdown, a non-conference basketball tournament spanning 2 weeks. The Bobcats' next match in the tournament will be Saturday at 4:30 against the Hartford Hawks. Meanwhile, the Bobcat football team will be facing Coastal Carolina Saturday afternoon on the road. The football team's conference record now stands at 2-5. Hays County wants more people to get their flu vaccinations. The County Commissioner's Court voted earlier today to promote flu vaccinations during the first week of December. The commissioners say there were about 4,700 people diagnosed with the flu in the county over the last 2 years. The CDC started this observance back in 2005 to call attention to the need for vaccines before flu season starts, which typically runs from December through February. Thanksgiving is only 2 days away, and that means plenty of people will be hitting the stores this weekend for Black Friday deals. San Marcos is home to two outlet malls covering more than 1 million square feet of retail space. And despite the size, the shops can still get crowded this time of year. The number of shoppers in San Marcos can triple during the holiday season. The outlet malls, in case you've never been there, are located at I-35 and Center Point Road. Center Point Station has been a staple in the San Marcos community for over 25 years, but now its days are numbered. Bobcat Update's Bryn McCurley tells us about plans to close the store.
Center Point Station has run into some troubles and will go out of business soon.
With all the growth that is happening out in this area, just become a family decision over the past couple of years. So we've decided to go ahead and close while we're doing well and offer great quality food until the time we close the doors.
A new customer of Center Point Station is sad to hear about the closing so soon after discovering it.
I came in with my sons and daughter-in-law. This was going to be one of our regular stops, and then I just heard that they're closing. So I decided to run by here and get some food to go so at least we could experience it as much as we could before they are gone.
Owner Cheryl Capitelli says she is touched to hear about the community's reaction.
It's been humbling because I had no idea that this little hamburger spot, you know, brought so many people so much joy.
Center Point Station's restaurant will be closing on December 15th. Their bakery will be closing on December 23rd, and then their boutique will be closing on December 31st. But all these dates are subject to change. For Bobcat Update, I'm Bryn McCurley.
Coming up after the break, we'll tell you about a couple of fundraisers for good causes, one of them in drag. Stay tuned. This is Bobcat Update. Information. With Thanksgiving only a few days away, many Texas State students are in the giving spirit. Bobcat Update's Sean Taggart tells us how one group is responding.
Saturday was the 8th annual Texas State Turkey Adventure Race. The race helps raise funds for the Association of Recreation Enthusiasts organization, but it also has a much larger impact on the Texas State community.
It really does. It brings the whole community together. We have several racers that aren't just within the recreation program, but as well as the community. There's several community people that just get real excited about it and make sure that they come race every year.
The race included several challenge stops where participants competed in fun and sometimes wacky games to advance in the competition and win prizes. Each of the events was hosted by a variety of student organizations at Texas State.
I think it's great. They're doing a food drive, and I know that that's a very important community event. I think it's important for the university. Everyone's cheering. They had lots of tour groups here today, and you can see smiles on their faces, seeing people enjoying the campus. It's a beautiful campus.
Not only does the event help the Association of Recreation Enthusiasts, but it also serves as a food drive to benefit Bobcat Bounty, the Texas State University extension of the Hays County Food Bank. The food bank is especially important this time of year as the holiday season approaches.
And if you'd like to make a difference this Thanksgiving, Please donate to your local food drive by visiting HayesCountyFoodBank.org. For Bobcat Update, I'm Sean Taggart. Have a happy and safe Thanksgiving.
Sights and sounds of Christmas return to the San Marcos Plaza Park on Wednesday, December 4th. The 33rd annual festival celebrates the holiday season with lighted displays, carnival rides, photos with Santa, food vendors, and much more. This year, a clear bag policy will be enforced. The only exception to this policy will be items needed for medical purposes or diaper bags. City officials say the clear bag policy will make the event safer and improve guest experience. The festival offers an exciting holiday celebration for people of all ages with live music and ice skating. Imagine an event filled with glam, glitter, fun, and carrots. Yep, carrots. They're all part of the raucous good time at Bunny Bingo, which takes place at the Spot Cinema and Social House. Bobcat Update's Darianne Valles has the story.
Bunny Bingo is an event hosted by Corey, aka Miss Bunny LaRocque. Bunny is a well-known drag queen in San Marcos who raises money in a fun and entertaining atmosphere and gives all the money to charity.
Bunny Bingo is a really great way for the community to come together and support each other. Every time they do Bunny Bingo, they choose a different charity to support. This time it's the Hayes County Food Bank.
This month's charity was the Hayes County Food Bank. People who came to the event were allowed to pay $10 or donate 3 canned goods for a playing card. After winners were announced, a drag queen puts on a show for the audience.
So this evening we are really hoping to actually fill the shelves of the food bank. They're really low this moment.
Carrots, bunny ears, and gift cards were among winning prizes. Not only does the event raise money for charity, but it also serves as a reminder that you can be whoever you want to be.
I guess all the community is just to not let people put you in a box, to step outside of the box, step out of your comfort zone, do something different, you know. If it's not being done, do it.
If you miss this month's Bunny Bingo, not to worry, because there will be another one next month on December 12th. All donations will go to the Blue Santa charity. For Bobcat Update, I'm Darian Vias. Now it's time to see if I want some bingo.
Texas State students can donate up to 3 of their unused meal swipes to help those suffering from hunger in San Marcos. Swipe Out Hunger agreed to match every donated swipe with a 75-cent donation. All of the proceeds go toward funding the on-campus food pantry called Bobcat Bounty. The student-led Bobcat Bounty serves the San Marcos area. Donations will be accepted from now until mid-December at 7 on-campus locations. Arbor Day is celebrated at Texas State in a time-honored tradition with the planting of trees. Bobcat Update's Michael Garcia has a story.
Trees are important to sustaining life on Earth. They provide a canopy for shade, bring beauty to landscapes year-round, and they produce oxygen. So, recognizing their importance seems fitting when tree planting ceremonies are held on Arbor Day. To celebrate the event at Texas State, staff and students planted 30 trees.
Arbor Day, we really kind of celebrate out here, trying to make sure our plan's doing great, planting as much trees as we can, just kind of day of help, like make sure the environment's going well.
Texas State University has been recognized by the Arbor Day Foundation as a Tree Campus USA school. Tree Campus USA promotes best practices in campus forestry. The goal of the program is to honor college campuses and the leaders of their surrounding communities for promoting healthy urban forest management and environmental stewardship.
As we build new buildings, we want to replace any of the trees that we took out in order to mitigate some of the heat island effects from urban areas and things like that.
30 assorted trees were planted, including red oak, desert willow, lacebark elm, and sycamore trees. For Bobcat Update, I'm Michael Garcia.
Leaves are a telltale sign of the fall season, but have you ever wondered how these colors come about? According to the Farmer's Almanac, yellow and orange trees have compounds called carotenoids in the leaf but are covered up by green chlorophyll in the summer. As days grow shorter and temperatures get cooler, chlorophyll goes from green to colorless and the trees begin to change in magnificent ways. It takes the perfect recipe of temperature and sunlight to produce these beautiful colors. Yes, tis the season, changing leaves, Thanksgiving, and time for a break. We'll return next semester with more of Bobcat Update. In the meantime, you can check out our YouTube channel for more of our reports. Thanks for joining us this afternoon. I'm Daisy Colon. Have a wonderful holiday.